Hello guys, today in this video tutorial I am gonna start working on a new sensor, that is HYT-939. Now, to have a better perspective regarding the temperature sensor and the humidity sensor, what we're gonna do is to look over the website, that is controleverything.com, and here search for this particular sensor, that is HYT-939, and let's see what we got. It's a humidity and temperature sensor with plus minus 1.8% RH, plus minus 0.2 degrees Celsius of temperature accuracy, as you can say, and these are some of its more features which are described clearly on the screen. Now you can also purchase the sensor from here. Well, I will be interfacing the humidity and temperature sensor HYT-939 with a Raspberry Pi and a Python code, and let's go to resource tab, and here comes the Python code sample. Now you can download the Python code sample as a zip file from here, just like that. And also you can have the code from GitHub repository, that is called Control Everything Community from github.com. Now collect some hardware so that we can interface and work out with this sensor along this in video. Let's have it. In the hardware section, first of all, the requirement is of a Raspberry Pi, which you can see on my screen, and this are the GPIO pins of the Raspberry Pi. Now this here is an I2C shield which is available on the website controleverything.com, and the real reason we are using is this I2C shield is to make connections with other I2C devices, and the connection should be a lot easier. That's why we use it, and gently place the I2C shield over the GPIO pins like this. Now what do we require is our sensor, that is humidity and temperature sensor HYT-939, and this here is a connecting cable. Now make the connection among the cable and the sensor, and make sure that the brown wire of the cable should be connected to the ground terminal of the sensor, and same goes for the I2C shield. Now we need to power up the Raspberry Pi, and for that we require a micro USB cable just like this, and gently insert it over the power jack of the Raspberry Pi. The final part is to provide the internet connection for the Raspberry Pi and the sensor, and there are two ways to do that. And the first way is to provide internet connection via a LAN cable or an Ethernet cable just like this, and gently insert it over the Ethernet jack. The second part is to use a wireless nano USB adapter just like this, and we are done with the connections part. Now what do we require is to have a look over the code. Let's have it. Now in the interfacing part, what do we require is to log in to the website github.com, and here we have to search for the repository, that is Control Everything Community. Now we go and we have a look over the code, as you can see, Python code. Now but before that, let's have a look over the instructions. We need to follow this code. As you can see, we have to download and install SMBus library on the Raspberry Pi, and this link will have the relative information regarding the steps to install the SMBus, and please note down all the relevant information, commands, installation guidances. Now get back to the code, but before that, it's the command which will run the Python code. Note it down. Now let's move on to the code. As you can see, .py is the extension, and in the code, the first thing you notice that we have imported SMBus and time libraries. Then we have the address of the sensor, that is 0x28, and we are writing a command. We are sending a command to send normal mode and 0x80. The writing command is here. After that, we are reading data back from 0x00, and we are reading 4 bytes of data for temperature and humidity. And after that, we have the conversion of the data into 14 bits, which is the guidance, the details according in the data sheet for HYT-939. After that, at the very end of our code, we have the output data on the screen to be displayed, which you can see the relative humidity in percentage RH along with the temperature in Celsius and Fahrenheit. And we have the data perfectly formatted for two places of floating point value. So this is a very generalized code, as you can see. Now what do we require is to show the practicality, the working of this code along with the sensor. Let's have it. Further, in the working environment session, what do we have to do is to, first of all, the copy the entire Python code, as you can see on my screen, and open up the terminal for the Raspberry Pi via internet. Here, create a new file, hyt939.py, which is an extension of the sensor, the Python code, and paste the code there, and then save the code, as you can see on my screen, and this is the command to run the sensor, the code, and we have relative humidity in percentage RH along with the temperature in Celsius and Fahrenheit. And as you can see, there is a very slight change, but when I blow some air over the sensor and run the command, you can see, and we have the relative humidity in percentage RH, and Then again, when I'm running the command, the changes are there visibly, or relative humidity and in temperature in Celsius and Fahrenheit. So this is how the sensor works along with the Python code and the Raspberry Pi. Now let's have a look over the benefits, the features and the applications which are very reliable on this very sensor, HYT939. Let's have it. Precisely calibrated, the HYT939 delivers an accuracy of ±1.8% RH and ±0.2°C. Further features are the integrated signal processing for measuring the physical parameters of relative humidity and temperature, the I2C compatible interface, easy interchangeability without adjustment, as well as mechanical robustness, chemical resistance, dew formation resistance, and long-term stability. The areas of applications for this particular sensor are medical systems, autoclaves, pressure dew point measurement, drying system, laboratories, and a lot more. Now, this sensor can be purchased and is easily available on the website controleverything.com, and you can have the code from the resource tab, and after that you can download the code as required. You can also have the code from github.com, and the repository there is Control Everything Community. Well, I hope you have understood everything, and in case of any further queries, you can reach us on controleverything.com and put your comments, show your comments on the community page. For blogs and articles which are relevant to this sensor or video, you can go to instructables.com, and to subscribe more video tutorials like this, go to our YouTube channel. In the end, I hope you enjoyed this video and have a good one yourself. Thanks a lot for watching.